Hello and welcome back to my DIY build. In this video I'm going to be fitting all the trucks together and fitting the heat sinks onto the battery case that I made in the previous videos. So in this one I'm just retrofitted it all together. I've taken some Loctite, I've used the green one on this one because it's a little bit more flexible than the blue that would be rock solid. And yeah, just generally just whizzing around, taking out the screws that I've pre-installed, putting the Loctite on and shoving them back in again. I'm now going to fit a rear light onto the back of the trucks just to make it a little bit more visible. I'm just going to super glue this in and then I'm going to fill the gaps with some Milput. It's just a 50-50 ratio mixed together, and then I will be fitting it all around the gaps to make sure that it's all kept solidly and looks a little bit smoother than just super glued on. And here we have the fiberglass case that I made in the previous videos. I've just given it a quick clean up, give it a little rub down with some sandpaper, and I'm now just going to use some more Milput, 50-50 split all the way over, just to raise the sides up a little bit and give me a nice flat surface to put the heatsink down for the electronics. Here's the heatsink that I've made. It's just a sheet of aluminium with two separate little heatsinks put on place. Now I've screwed those in and stuck them down with some thermal conductive tape, which I will also be sticking on the back of the main heatsink for the electronics. What I've just mounted here is two fuse holders to protect the vesk. This is the back of the vesk where the heatsink is. I'm just giving it a quick clean before I stick on the thermal conductive tape I used to put the previous heatsinks on, and this will be mounted to the larger heatsink you've just seen. Turn the heatsink over. I've stuck on some industrial grade double-sided sticky tape. This will be stuck onto the fiberglass case with the two little heatsinks poking through the bottom so they get cooled by the air as I ride. Now I'm just going to tidy up the cables, put in the power switch and use a little bit of heat shrink all over the exposed electronics, and to use just to tidy up the cables a little bit. Okay, so that's the heatsink done. The vesk is now connected to the heatsink, the power connections are there, and it's all ready to be connected up to the board in the next video.